UK Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Yep. Today we'll be discussing the controller. So as part of controller, okay, here first of all, before we discuss controller, we are trying to understand the frequently used terminology here in controller. Okay, these are the different things that we are going to come across. So here we firstly took EDA application, and say a business analyst, say a business analyst said that now my EDA application will be used by 50,000 users in a day, and he said that there are four scenarios. So the scenarios are like this. And again, business in, business analyst or the client, it can be anyone, okay? They said that, no, this is the scenario which will be used by 5,000 users. This is the scenario which will be used by 30,000 users. This is the scenario which will be used by 10,000. And the next scenario will be used by, say, 5,000 users. Like this, say, business analyst may come with some numbers and some scenarios over here. Okay, however, technically here the total load, I mean the number of users or the load will be called here in this particular example is 50,000 users over here. In simple terms, the total number of users are going to be tested on the application. So here 50,000 users. Okay. And now we are going to discuss about concurrent users or load. Any idea from any guesses from anyone? What is meant by concurrent users or concurrent load? Yep. That's pretty simple. It's nothing. Actually here in a day I'm saying 50,000 users are logged into the application, right? But when you take at a particular point of time, okay, when you take at a particular point of time, what is the concurrent number of users? Maybe say for example here in GoToMeeting, just for example in a GoToMeeting, in a day there might be thousands of meetings might be going on, right? There might be thousands of meetings going on. But at this particular point of time, say at this 11:15 a.m. EST, okay? At this 11:15 a.m. EST, how many people are joined? That is matters. That is called as concurrent users. At a particular point of time, how many simultaneous users are there in the system, which will be called as concurrent users? Okay. Yes, 1 minute. Okay, so at a particular point of time, how many simultaneous users are there in a application or a system will be called as concurrent users or concurrent load. Okay. Say for example, everyone agree here. I hope everyone of you understood this particular point. Any questions on these two? Any questions on these two? Because the next one is depends on these two. That's the reason I'm asking here. If any questions, please post over here. Please be respond, you know. Don't be idle. Say yes or no. If you don't really understand, please say it as no. Please mention it as no. Okay, I'm assuming that everyone understood. That's great. Great. So now here there is another word called as maximum concurrent users. It means we understood that the total number of users will be logged into the application will be 50,000, and at a particular point of time, how many users are currently logged in or simultaneously logged in? Okay, maybe currently. Currently our simultaneous users are there in the application will be called as a concurrent user or concurrent load. And there is something called maximum concurrent. Any guesses on this? Any guesses on this one from anyone? What it could be? Okay, fine. Say for example, we understood that here eBay load. Say here eBay, we understood that eBay in a day, in a 24 hours duration, it is going to be fifty thousand users, right? So for example, say we observed, assume everyone agree here. Say at around 6 a.m. in the morning, say 6 a.m. in the morning, we observe that there are 350 concurrent users. We know that, right? Here we know concurrent users. It means at this in the morning time at 6 a.m. there were 350 users are currently logged into this particular eBay application, like that. Say here. Around 8 a.m. say it was around 790 users were logged into the were there. Okay, and say again some 11 a.m. there were 6,000 concurrent users there. Users were there at the time. And let me say around 3 p.m. say let me say there were 7,500 users, I mean concurrent users. And say here around 7 p.m. say there were around 15,000 concurrent users were there. And say around 10 p.m. say around there are 2,000 users were there. Again let me say here around 1 a.m. say there are 100 concurrent users were there. Of course, when we accumulate this, I mean when we accumulate all these concurrent users, it should not be more than 50,000 users. But however, among these concurrent users, I mean it just for example, actually I know it should be like each and every time. But however, here among these times, I mean among these samples that I mentioned over here. What is the maximum number at which time you observe the maximum number of concurrent users over here? At which time you have? At which time? Of course, you have to consider this also. Okay. Among these times, okay. At which time? At which particular point of time we got the maximum number of users? So here the maximum number of users we can call it as a 15,000 over here. Okay, this is called as maximum concurrent users. Okay, we know what is concurrent users. We know simply what is concurrent users. But here, during one execution, I mean during one day, the maximum number of concurrent users are 15,000 here. Okay, the maximum number of concurrent users was observed 15,000. It means it reached maximum of 15,000 maximum number of concurrent users over here. Okay, sometimes client will say that you know, why I'm showing, why I'm explaining this clearly, sometimes clients say that, you know, my application will be used by 2,000 people, but my maximum concurrent, my application should able to, should have a capability of maximum concurrent users should be 600 users. Client says that my application will be used by in total 2,000 users, but the maximum concurrency should be maintained by 600 users. Okay, so maximum concurrent users means he wanted to maintain that the application should able to accept 600 users at a time. Okay, at a time the application should have the capability to handle 600 users, and of course entire duration it is going to be used by 2,000 users. Okay, fine. So now we have been trying to understand these three. Okay, now we have something called ramp up, duration, ramp down. Now we have been trying to understand the number of users, right? Say for example, here we understood like eBay. Here we have this application, and we assume that there are 50,000 users who are going to be used by eBay application. Okay, whenever we wanted to test the application using this 50,000 users, okay, say practically if we speak out, are these 50,000 users are going to log into the eBay application at a time? Just forget about this load runner, this performance testing and all. Say for example, you want to buy a product. Even myself, I want to buy a product in eBay. Yourself and myself, are we going to log into the eBay application at the same time? No, right? Probably you may log in the morning time, I may log in the evening time. But however, in a day, it is going to be 50,000 users. Okay. So here, whenever we wanted to test the application, okay, whenever we wanted to test the application, okay. So here, whenever we wanted to test the application with the 50,000 users, we don't need to test that application with the 50,000 users suddenly logged into the application, right? Practically, whenever you wanted to execute the scenario, is my voice clear for everyone? Is my voice clear? Anusundar, could you please set at your end? Maybe I think you need to increase your volume. Others can hear me. Are you able to follow this? Fine, let's move on. So here, I know practically when we speak, of course, in a real time, I mean, without considering all this performance testing and all, really, I know whenever we have an eBay application, some users may log in it sometime, some users may log in it other time. Even though application is going to be used by the 50,000 users, all the users will not log in at the same time. So while doing the performance testing also, you don't need to log in all the 50,000 users to the application. Okay, one point, first point. Second point is, see, even though you wanted to log in your application, if you want to test your application with 50,000 users, okay, if you start pumping, basically I can say it's pumping up the users to the application. Basically ramping up means pumping up the users to the application. Okay, so if you start pumping 50,000 users at a time to the application, suddenly it may affect the server performance. I mean, server may get crashed because suddenly 50,000 users has been pumped into the application. So there might it may happen with the application crash. The server may get crashed, and moreover, practically also it is not recommended. Right? Practically also, I mean, in a real time also, all the users will not log in at the same time. So that's the reason you don't need to pump the users suddenly. Don't pump the users suddenly to the application. Say if you are planning to test the application with 50,000 users or 500 users or some 50 users, it might be any number of users. Don't pump the users suddenly to the application. it may it may crash the application, it may crash the server, and moreover, in a practically, when you think normally, practically also, all the users will not log into the application suddenly. So slowly some users will be logged into the application. That's the reason, don't pump up the users suddenly. Okay. To the application, okay. It may crash. Application, servers, some hardware. It might be anything. Okay. So this is a recommended point. And basically, ramp up means we'll pumping up the users to the application. And generally, there is a kind of a scenario like. For every say, for example, where we wanted to test the 50,000 users, probably we may say that for every 1 minute, okay, maybe I will say 3 users. Okay, say here for every 1 minute I want to pump up the 3 users, something like this I can configure. Or there might be, it all depends on the application that you are going to work, that you are going to log in, that you are going to test. Maybe eBay is a kind of a commercial website. That's the reason I'm saying for every 1 minute I'm saying 3 users. Okay, but there might be some things like, there will be some applications which will be like suddenly they say, for example, if it is a cricket match, maybe at a particular point of time suddenly there will be a huge number of users may log in. In that case we'll say that for every 3 seconds, some 5 users, like that. Okay, but however, our agenda will be like, instead of pumping up all the users suddenly to the server, we'll pump up it slowly to the server. Okay, it has 2 advantages, because in a real time, even when you want to test the application with 50,000 users or how many number of users it might be, okay, we'll not pump all the users suddenly at the same time. Okay, it all depends on the user behavior. One user may log in at 11 a.m. One user may log in at 11:03 a.m. It all depends. Okay, and moreover, if you do that, it may crash the application. It may crash the server. So, however, ramp up means pumping up the users to the application slowly here. Okay, and similarly, we have something called ramp down. Again, it's opposite to this. Again, say we are we wanted to stop the execution. Okay, so don't stop the execution. I mean, don't pull out all the users suddenly from the application. Okay, don't stop the users suddenly from the application. Again, that may affect the server issue again. What will happen? Say you are holding some 5 kgs of weight by your hand. And if you suddenly drop it down, it may give some kind of sudden shock, right? So what you have to do, you have to slowly pull down, you have to slowly lose that weight. You should not suddenly lose it. I mean, you should not suddenly stop holding it. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to slowly kept it somewhere. So in a similar way, ramp down is something like pumping down the users. From the application, and again I'm saying that don't pump down the so what will happen if you do that, maybe it will suddenly the server may get stuck. Our application may get stuck because you are suddenly trying to stop all the users. So don't do that. Okay. So again, what we'll do here, for every say for every 5 minutes, some 20 users need to log in like this. Like this, I can configure as part of ramp down over here. there is something called duration. Duration means here, say you have logged into the application, okay? You have logged into the application and you are saying that you want to log out from the application. Basically, this duration will be in between ramp up and ramp down. I mean the time of execution, how much time that you want to execute, okay? The time user should execute, okay? And here basically it is in between ramp up and ramp down, okay? So duration is basically it is in between the ramp up and ramp down, okay? And moreover here, here we have two types of durations. Basically here as part of durations we will be having two types. One is run until completion. And you can specify some time. Any guesses from anyone by looking at these two? Any guesses what is meant by run until completion? What is specify some time? Any guesses from anyone over here? Just give a guess. Devin, it's not related to scripting and all, it's a general thing. Any guesses from anyone? Any other guesses? Just the name itself is saying clearly. Just think. Yeah, Devin is saying when meet the requirement, complete the process. Okay. Yeah. Here, everyone up there. Basically, don't think too much here. I know there is no loop and all. Don't think towards scripting here. If you agree, I am just saying in a very, very generic words only, right? Yep. Here I can see good guess from Islam. That's great, Islam. Yep, that is correct. Yep, Islam is saying that if you have 5 iteration, run and finish as needed. Yep. Okay, let me copy these things. Now Islam is saying that if you have 5 iteration and run and finish as it needed, yeah, that is correct. One minute. Yep, another is saying application should be running with some users. Yep, fine. Yep, that's correct, Anuradha and Anu. Yep, however, you know it's directly this it here itself is saying run until completion means. Say for example, again, just keep it somewhere. I mean, I don't know what I can do here. Forget about all these things. Again, just by thinking. Yep. Now see here. Say we have a scenario. Okay. Say like a registration scenario. User has to open the application and user has to complete the registration scenario. Okay. Some users may take 2 minutes. Some users may take 3 minutes. But however, say once the user is done with the registration, okay, say user want to log out from the application. Now can you guess? Say for example, an average registration process is taking around 3 minutes. Okay, I mean for different users, say an average it is taking 3 minutes. So here can you guess what would be the run until completion? It means after executing the registration scenario, automatically that particular user will log out from the application. When you say run until completion. When you say run until completion, okay, say the registration scenario is taking 3 minutes. After the registration process is done, after it took the time which is required for the scenario, okay, say for some user, one user it is taking 2 minutes and some user it is taking 2.5 minutes, and some other user it is taking 3 minutes. Are you able to follow this one? I'm saying for one user it is 2 minutes, the other user is 2.5 minutes, 3 minutes. Okay? Because why I'm saying one user, the other user and all? Because here we are talking about 50,000 users. Okay? For one user, that one user may be a bit fast in filling up the application form. Did you all remember this we have discussed as part of think time? Did you all remember? As part of think time, we can randomly select the think time. Did you all remember think time pacing? See, yes or no, say something. Okay? So, in that case, of course, however, so here, so one user say it is taking 2 minutes. Okay? So after completion of that registration process, the user will log out if it is a run until completion. Okay, say if you specify a time, like say I want to execute for 20 minutes here. Say I want to execute my 20 minutes. So even though the user is completed, say even though the user is done with their execution, say registration process took around 3 minutes. Even the user is done with the registration process, user will write still in the system. User will not log out from the application. Is it clear? Are you able to follow this? So when you say specify sometime, basically we will not use in real time this one. In real time, we will not use this specify sometime. I mean, we will not basically mention, will not use this until unless it is required. There will be there will be some applications where in which we may come across the, but it is very, very rare cases. Okay. So here when you say 20 minutes over here, what it will do? Even though your registration process is done for 2 minutes, it is going to wait for remaining 18 seconds here in the application itself. It will not log out from the application. Okay. Whereas here, run until completion means once the execution is done, once after 2 minutes the registration process is done, once it is done with its execution, okay, it will log out from the application. Because I'm saying run until completion means once the scenario is completed, it will ramp down. It will automatically ramp down. But whereas here, if you specify some 20 minutes, okay, even though they say, for example, your scenario is taking 25 minutes to execute. Say, for example, your scenario is taking 25 minutes, but here, here you mentioned 20 minutes. Even though you mentioned it is going to take 25 minutes, after 20 minutes, automatically user will ramp down because you have mentioned 20 minutes only here. But whereas here it will wait for 25 minutes because you mentioned 25 minutes over here. I hope everyone is following this particular example. Any questions till this point? Any questions ramp down, ramp up, duration? Any questions till this point? If you have any questions, please post here in the chat box. If it is clear for you, please mention as clear. Don't be idle. Controller, it is a part of the load runner component. Okay, by using controller we can execute the scripts. So whatever we have been discussing on the virtual user generator, that is basically, we are just creating one script, we are correlating, we are parameterizing, and we are configuring the scripts. But whatever, whenever you execute a script in virtual user generator, that was with respect to only one user, right? Whatever you have been executing in virtual user generator, that is basically only one user, with respect to only one user. And moreover, if you install LoadRunner, okay, basically it will be creating three components: virtual user generator, controller, analysis, and virtual user generator. The license for the virtual user generator is for the lifetime. Okay, it will be for the lifetime. You can use at any point of time. But whereas the controller, the lifetime for the controller will be only 1 month. Why? Because here in the main component of virtual LoadRunner is controller. Because here this is the actual place where in which you can kick off the LoadRunner performance testing. Without controller, you cannot execute the performance scripts. With virtual user generator, basically you can create the virtual user scripts. You can execute with respect to only one user, but you cannot execute more than one user. Maybe you can execute in the iterations, but that iteration is a kind of sequence. It is not parallel. Okay, that execution, whatever the execution that you are going to do, that may be a kind of a sequence execution that cannot be a parallel execution. If you want to have a parallel execution, you need to have something called controller. Okay, so in the controller, basically configure. Here, we observe that you know, client may say that client wants some requirement like this. So these kind of things can be achieved only here in the load runner, in the controller over here. Okay. Now here we know that this is a virtual user script. All this code will be virtual user script. For each scenario will be having one virtual user script, and will be having some load over here. Okay. Fine. However, you know, whatever you create in the controller will be called as a scenario. It means, say here in a Excel software, I mean in this particular Excel, what we can create some Excel sheets, we can create some Excel workbooks, right? Here in Excel software, we can create the Excel workbooks or Excel sheets. In a similar way, in a controller, whatever we are going to create, it will be called as a scenario over here. I hope you are able to follow what I'm saying. Okay. In a controller, we'll be creating something called, the file name will be called as a scenario. Okay. Whatever you create in the controller, it will be called as a scenario. If you remember, here, you know, in virtual user generator, what we are going to create? Yep. See here, in a virtual user generator, we'll be creating something called VU script, virtual user. Maybe we'll call it as a virtual user, and simply we will call it as a virtual user, or we can say VU script. Okay, these are the things that we are going to create as part of the VU generator. Whereas here in the controller, we'll be using something called, we'll be creating something called scenario over here. Technically, we call it as a scenario. Okay. Now, this scenario basically it is going to contain. Okay, I can say this is equivalent to virtual user script. Yes. Load. What is when we load? What is when we load? Okay. What is when we users? If that's what actually here, that's the reason I have explained here. Can you see if there is something called users load? Okay, don't get confused. Okay, here users are load, which is nothing but the number of users load. Okay, so maybe for this particular scenario, I mean for one virtual user script, we'll have a part of users over here. Okay, generally here it will contain a virtual user script plus load. Load means the number of users that you want to execute on that particular scenario. Okay, for each scenario you will be creating one virtual user script. Okay, and there we have some load and load generator. So load generator means basically here we know what is virtual user script, we know what is meant by load. Now load generator means this is a machine basically which will generate some load over here. Okay, maybe let me keep you over here. Load generator. Yep. A machine which generates the load. Again, what is meant by load? Basically, load is nothing but the virtual users, right? The users. Say here we wanted to execute our EB application on 50,000 users. So that 50,000 users has to generate from somewhere, right? I mean, here it is all virtual. Why we are getting into the performance testing, load runner performance testing? Because in a manual testing, in a manual performance testing, basically we cannot hire a 50,000 users, right? Okay. So all this load has been generating it from a machine. Okay. This is the machine where the basically load is going to generate. Okay. So now here, for example, if you remember, Devon was asking one question over here. Like, you know, here I was asking one question. EB application on different countries, how do we manage these users? Okay. Now for this, say for example, now say here, just for example, say this registration scenario. Everyone observe that we understood that registration scenario will be executed by will be used by 5,000 users. Okay, among these 5,000 users, assume, say, among these 5,000 users, okay, say some 3,000 users are, say 3,000 users are from USA. Okay, some 1,500 users are from, say, UK, and say from 500 users are from other countries. Okay, or let me say India. Okay, now everyone observe. Now if you observe, say this is a scenario, and we know that it is going to be used by 5,000 users. Okay, now again, getting into the details, say for example, this scenario is being in a practically in the sense, in average, okay, say one user, some set of users has been generating, 3,000 users has been, say a business analyst says that in an average, there will be some 3,000 users are getting registered from USA country, USA. And say 1,500 users are getting registered from the UK, and 500 users are registered from the India. Say business analyst said that my registration scenario will be accessible, will be used by 5,000 users, okay, and 3,000 users from the USA, and 1,500 users from UK, and the 500 users from India. It's all like a kind of random average numbers based on their metrics, based on their business strategy. They will come up with these numbers. Okay, generally business analyst or the client will come with these numbers based on their surveys, strategies, okay, previous experiences. They will come with these numbers over here. Okay, now here what you have to do over here, if you have a scenario like this, say for example, if you want to emulate, if you want to have this kind of scenarios, what you can do here, you can keep some load generator. You can keep some load generator in USA country. And you can keep some load generator, one machine. You can keep one machine in USA, you can keep one machine in UK, and you can keep one machine in India. Okay. Now you have to connect all these three machines to your controller over here. I will show how all these things practically, don't worry. Practically in the sense, I know I will not keep any machine in any country, okay. Again, don't get into that. Fine. So here in controller, what I can do here, we can keep one machine. We can have our machine in USA, okay, one machine in UK, one machine in India, and we'll connect these three machines to our controller scenario. I said in a controller we'll be having a scenario, right? For that scenario we'll be connecting these three scenarios. But however, here if you close the observer, this scenario has to be executed 5,000 users. But here the thing is, 3,000 users on USA. What we'll do here, once you have confidence, once you are done with the script creation of this test registration, TS1 registration. Okay, once it is perfectly working fine, once this virtual user script is perfectly working fine, what you have to do, you have to save this particular script into another two save as. Maybe you can save it as _1. Like this. Okay, so once you are creating your virtual user script, what you have to do here, you have to save this. I'm saying actually practical thing over here. Okay, practically if you really have a requirement like this, okay, practically, basically in a simple words, load generator means a machine which generates a load. But I'm extending this particular topic practically to understand you what is this load generator, how it works and all. So here we have a scenario where in which we wanted to execute 5,000 users, and this is a distribution of the load. So what I can do here, I can have these users like this. Okay, now see here, I will save this particular script as 1_1_2_3. So I will have this script with this load and the machine. I mean here 3,000 users, you will be mentioning 3,000 users. From where you want to generate these 3,000 users means, you will mention the load generator machine name over here. Give me a minute, let me show what actually I'm talking about. So in the controller, what I'm saying here, you will be having virtual user script load plus load generator, right? So here I will be saying that, 1 minute, I'll say that for example, I know, just for example, say here, Merlin is from, let me say, say in our H2K Infosys, say we have a machine in H2K Infosys at Atlanta, okay? Let me say H2K over here. Some H2K, MASC machine, machine 001. This is the name of the machine, and this is this we have in an HTK Atlanta's machine, okay? And say here, say for example here, we have this particular scenario, this particular script over here. So, and let me say here, this is a scenario. And say here we have 1500 users, and here we have a machine like, say UK machine. Say again we have HTK UK 005. This is the one machine which is being there in HTK Infosys in UK. Okay, and say here, again say some HTK, and again some, let me say IN 006. Some machine which is installed in, which is there in India. So these three machines will be there in their respective locations. One is USA, one is UK, India, and these are the scripts over here. And the same script is being saved as like three scripts. And based on, say, this is a USA machine, so I wanted to execute with 3000 users. Okay, so accordingly I will be configured like this. This is for this first scenario here. Okay, this is for registration, right? Basically, this all these things which represents the registration. In a similar way for book items, say book items is saying that 30,000 items, and say again it is being distributed like out of this 30,000 30,000 users, say I know around 20,000 users are from.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.